I will start with a light green. I've made a foundation chain of 55. And now I will close the chain with the slip stitch into the first chain. And this is the first chain. I will insert, yarn over, pull through, and pull through. So now I've made a circle. And now I will chain two, one and two. And in the first chain of the beginning, I will make two double crochet. So yarn over, insert in the chain, pull up the yarn, yarn over and pull through two, yarn over and pull through two. And I will make another double crochet, yarn over, insert, pull up the yarn over, pull through two, yarn over and pull through two. And now I will chain two, one and two. And in the same space, in the first chain, I will make three double crochet. So, one, insert in the same space, two, and I will make another one. And this is three. And now, on top of this chain tool, I will insert a stitch marker. And now I will skip two chain, one and two, and in a third chain, I will make three double crochet. So one, two, and three. And I will repeat this until I have a total of 11 bundles of 3 double crochet. I'll also count this first 2 double crochet with the chain 2. So I will skip 2 chain 1 and 2 and in the third I will make 3 double crochet. 1 2 and 3. So continue this until I have 11. So now I've made 11 groups of 3 double crochet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11. And now I'm in this corner and I will chain two, one and two, in the same chain where I've made the three double crochet, I will make another three double crochet. So in the same space, one, two, 2 and 3. So this is the corner. In this part I will increasing all the time, and I will put a stitch marker on top of the chain tool. And now I will continue making 3 double crochet. I will skip 2, chain 1 and 2, and in the third I will make 3 double crochet. So 1, 2 and 3, and continue this until the end of the row, when I have a total of 20 bundles of 3 double crochet. I'm now at the end of row 1. I've made a total of 20 bundles of 3 double crochet. And now I will change the color and go to the second row. Therefore, I will insert into the first stitch, and I will grab the new color, I'll pull it around and pull it through the loops. And now I will pull the old color to tighten it up, and I will make a slip stitch until the first middle part. So insert, yarn over and pull through, insert and pull through. Now I arrived at the first space where I've put the stitch marker. I will remove the stitch marker. And now I will chain 2, 1 and 2. In this space I will make 2 double crochet, 1 and 2, and now I will chain 2, 1 and 2. In the same space I will make 3 double crochet. One, two, and 3. And I will put the stitch marker back in the middle part on the chain tool. So keep pulling the stitch marker back in this space. And now I will skip 3 double crochet in the space between those 2 bundles. I will make 3 double crochet. One, two, and 3. And I will hop over to the next space, and I will make 3 double crochet, 1, 2, and 3, and I will keep repeating this pattern until the end of the row. I've made all these bundles of 3 double crochet, and I arrived at the next stitch marker. I will remove this, and into the middle part I will make 3 double crochet. So 1, 2 and 3. And I will chain 2, 1 and 2, and in the same space I will make 3 double crochet, 1, 2 and 3, and I will put the stitch marker back in the middle part on top of the 2 chain, and I will repeat the pattern. I will skip 3 double crochet, and into the space I will make 3 double crochet, so 1, 2 and 3, and repeat this until I'm at the end of the row. I arrived at the last stitch. In this stitch I also make 3 double crochet, 1, 2 and 3, so I've made a total of 22 bundles of 3 double crochet stitches in this row, and now I'm going to make a new color. I will insert into the first stitch of the beginning, and I will grab the new color, put it around and pull through the loops, and I will pull the old color and I will cut the yarn of the old color, and now I will make a slip stitch until the middle where I've put the stitch marker, so 1 and 2. I arrived at the middle part, and I will remove the stitch marker, and like in the previous row I will chain 2, 1 and 2, and I will make 2 double crochet, 1 and 2, and now I will chain 2, 1 and 2, in the same space I will make 3 double crochet, 1, 2 and 3, and now I will put the stitch marker back in the middle part of those 2 bundles, and I will continue my work. I will skip 3 double crochet, and into the hole I will make another 3 double crochet, 1, 2 and 3, and hop over to the next 1, 2 and 3. So continue this until I'm back at the next stitch marker on this side. I arrived at the corner. I will remove the stitch marker, and in the corner I will make 3 double crochet, 1, 2 and 3, and I will chain 2, 1 and 2, and in the same space I will make another 3 double crochet, 1, 2 and 3, and I will put the stitch marker back in the middle part of the corner on top of the chain tool. And now I will continue the row, making 3 double crochet on each space. So skip the 3 double crochet and make 3 double crochet until the end of the row. I'm at the end of the third row. And I will insert into the first stitch and wrap the yarn and pull it through. Now I will make 2 slip stitches until the middle of the first corner. In the corner where I've put the stitch marker, I will remove the stitch marker. And now I will chain 2, 1 and 2. In the middle part I will make 2 double crochet, 1 and 2, and now chain 2, 1 and 2. In the same space I will make 3 double crochet. So 1, 2, and 3. And now I will put the stitch marker back in the middle part in the corner. And I will continue with the fourth row, making a bundle of 3 double crochet in each space. I will skip 3 double crochet and I will make 3 double crochet. So continue this part on each row. And each row you will increase a bundle of 3 double crochet. I arrived at the other corner, and now I will remove the stitch marker, and in the same space I will make 3 double crochet. So 1, 2, and 3, and I will chain 2, 1 and 2, and in the same space I will make another 3 double crochet. So 1, 2, and 3. And I will put the stitch marker back in the corner on top of the 2 chain. So you keep repeating this corner. So each time when you arrived at the stitch marker, you will make 3 double crochet, chain 2, and 3 double crochet. Now let's continue on the other side. In each hole you will make 3 double crochet. I'm now at the end of row 4. I've made a total of 26 groups of these 3 double crochet. And now I will move over to row 5. I'll insert in the last stitch. I'll grab my new color and pull it through the loops. And just pull on the old collar to tighten it up. And now I will make two slip stitches to go to the middle of the next corner. And I will remove the slip stitch. I will remove the stitch marker. And just like in the previous corner, I will chain two, one and two. Into the first space, I will make two double crochet. One and two, and now I will chain two, one and two, and in the same space I will make three double crochet. And so I will put the stitch marker back on the on this part, and I will continue with these rows, and on each corner you will increase three double crochet stitches. I've made 13 rows. I'm now at the end of the 13th row, and I will make one slip stitch to close the row. So you have to weave in the ends. It's a lot of loose ends, but I've already done this. And this is how your poncho looks. I really love this color combination. And now I will start with the hood. I've made a foundation chain of 68. And I will start in the third chain. 1, 2, and 3. And in this chain, I will make two double crochet. So one and two. And now I will skip to the chain, 1, 2. And in the third chain, I will make three double crochet. So, 1, 2, and 3. And I will skip two chain, 1 and 2. And in the third chain, I will make three double crochet. So, 1, 2, and 3, and repeat this in the first row. I'm at the end of the first row. I've made a total of 22 bundles of 3 double crochet, and now I have 2 chain left. In the last chain, I will make 1 double crochet. Now I will go to the next color, which is a lilac color. I'll yarn over and pull it through. And yarn over 2 strands and pull through the loop. And make 1 more chain. So you've made 2 chain. And turn my work and start with row 2 in the first space between those 3 double crochet and the 1 double crochet. I will make 2 double crochet. 1 and 2. And now I will skip 3 double crochet. In the next space, I will make 3 double crochet, 1, 2, and 3, and repeat this in row 2. Skip 3 double crochet, and in the space, you make 3 double crochet. I'm at the end of row 2. I've made a total of 22 bundles of 3 double crochet. And now I will make 1 double crochet onto the first stitch, which is the chain 2 of the beginning of row 1. And now I will change the color into the dark green. Yarn over and pull through. Yarn over 2 strands and make 1 chain and use 1 strand to make 1 more chain. I will cut the lilac color and I will turn my work and start with row 3. In row 3, into the first space, I will make 2 double crochet, 1 and 2, and I will skip 3 double crochet. Into the next space, I will make 3 double crochet, and just like in the previous rows, I'll repeat this in this row. So in each space, you will make 3 double crochet. And again, make 22 bundles of these 3 double crochet. I'm at the end of the third row and I will make a double crochet into the last stitch of this row. So again, in this row I've made 22 bundles of 3 double crochet, and I will move to the next color, which is this ochre. Yarn over and pull through, yarn over the 2 threads and make a chain and make 1 more chain with 1 strand and turn the work and start with row 4. In the first space I will make 2 double crochet, 1 and 2, and just like in the previous row, in each space I will make 3 double crochet, and keep repeating these rows. I've made 16 rows. And now I'm going to fold the head together. And I sew in 1 part. So insert in the corner. So you go all the way until this part. So you can fold this part open. Only sew this part. So I sewed this part together. And now I'm going to attach it to the poncho. Therefore, I will use the inside out, the middle part of the head, I will attach into the corner. First, I will sew it. I will attach it with some needles. So you put it all around and also on the other side. So now I'm just checking if it's in the middle part. Well, this is the middle part. Here's one. Yeah, it looks like I'm okay. So you can see it when I put the head inside out. It looks like a really big head, but it's okay. And now I will grab my needle and start sewing again. I'll start on this front part. It may not look really tidy, but you will not see this part again, so this is no problem. So you continue all the way around the neck part until you reach the other side. I finished sewing the head to the poncho. It looks like a really big head, but this is how the front looks like.